Yes, and DFT, these two are not a different things, almost equal only. Okay. DDFS means discrete time Fourier series. That is, trinomial signal is in the discrete in nature, and the, because of the Fourier series term, the trinomial signal should be in the periodic in nature. So, the trinomial signal is the discrete and periodic in nature. Discrete and periodic in nature. And already we have seen one table, discrete and periodic. Okay, the corresponding frequency domain is from the table. The corresponding frequency is also because of the discrete, periodic, and because of this periodic, discrete. Because of periodic, discrete. In the frequency domain also, the corresponding signal will be periodic and discrete. Okay. Before that, we will see some information about these periodic signals. Information about the periodic signal. Consider a signal x of n. Consider a discrete n signal x of n is equal to 1, 2, 3 from start from. One because of this period is equal to half period is equal to 3, 1, 2, 3, half period is equal to 3. So after 3, this output will be repeated again. Repeated again. These are the corresponding discrete signal I am conjuring. I am going to write one x of n minus 1, x of n minus 1, x of n minus 1 means delayed by 1 unit in the right side. So shifting of one unit in the right side means it will become 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3. So the 0 mark will appear here. And x of n minus 2, I am writing x of n minus 2. Again, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And now the 0 will appear at 2. 0 will appear at 2. Now again, I am writing this x of n minus 3. One more thing, writing x of n minus 3. That will become what? No. Because of the, instead of that, we write x of n plus 1. X of n plus 1 is equal to simply 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, up to so on. Up to 7, and where the this arrow will be just this arrow is at 2 because of this n plus 1 is equal to 0, n is equal to minus 1. Then minus 1 add to this one, add to this one. So this one will appear at the minus 1, this one will appear at the 0, this one will appear at the 0. 0. Now I am representing this x of n on the circle, y on the circle, on the circle, on the period representation on the circle. Just treat it like a your wall clock only. Okay, so this is the clockwise direction. This is the direction we are moving. We are moving as on the linear scale. We are moving from in this direction. That is similar to the in this circle. In this circle, we are moving in the on the same direction only. In this direction only. Okay, that direction and this direction is same. The corresponding values are represented as n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, whatever. Here we are having up to 2 only. So I consider only n equal to 0, n equal to 1, n equal to 2. If period is equal to 5, we have to consider from n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to that. We have to consider on this clock. The direction is always like this one. Direction is always in the clockwise direction only. Always in the clockwise direction only. Now, x of n minus 1. X of n minus 1 means shifting. Shifting all these by one unit into right side, one unit into left side, right, one unit into left side, from right side to left side. There is nothing but right side, left side, nothing but. So the shift in this circle, in this wise. So in this circle representation, this is also for samples. The samples are shift one unit in clockwise direction because this is moving from right to left. They are moving one unit is moving from right to left. So one unit is moving from the clockwise direction, and this will become, and the corresponding will be this always fix n equal to 0, n equal to 1, and n equal to 2. By shifting these two, we will get like this 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. This is the corresponding here equal to corresponding equal to 1, 2, 3. Here is the corresponding 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. This 3, 1, 2, and this 3, 1, 2. Again, one more shift, one more, 1 minus 2 is nothing but shifting of these two units in the right side, in the left side direction, is nothing but in the clockwise direction. Here, this one will be appear at least this one. 1, 2 and 3. The corresponding can be represented as a 0, 1, 2. Corresponding can be represented as a 2, 3, 1. 2, 3, 1. This is the corresponding representation for x of n minus 2. Coming to this x of n plus 1. N plus 1 is nothing but shifting of this from left to right side. From left to right side. So the similar way, circular point of view. Just shift one unit in the anti-clockwise direction. One unit in the anti-clockwise direction. That is nothing but this is where n equal to 0, n equal to 1 and n equal to 2. Earlier equal to n equal to 1. So in the anti-clockwise direction by 1 unit. So we start from here. So this is the way of shifting this periodic sequences periodic sequences in the advance and the delay. In delay means representation is always, this is your 0 n equal to 0, this is your n equal to 0. So we are writing n equal to 0 means from right to left side, The corresponding is the clockwise direction, n equal to 0, 1, 2 like this. And here is n equal to 0, 1, 2 like that. Okay, because for one period information, we have to represent in the clockwise, in this circle. One period information, you have to represent in this circle, the n equal to 0, 1, 2. The corresponding example values are 1, 2, 3. Now, for x of n minus 1, that is nothing but shifting, shifting all the samples one unit into the left hand direction. Left hand direction is nothing but in the clockwise direction. In the clockwise direction, so one unit shifted is 1 into this place. Again, we have to write blindly, you can write 1, 2, 3 like that. For n minus 2, shifting in the 2 units. So this is 1 unit and this is 2 units. So 1, 2 will appear here. So 1, 2 will appear here, 1, 2, 3. This is always 6 n equal to 0, 1, 2. As the time axis is always 6 n equal to 0, 1, 2. Here also, the representation is always fixed. Only the sample values are going to be changes for x of n minus 1. Moving in the clockwise direction by 1 unit, for x of n minus 2, moving in the clockwise direction by 2 units, coming to this effect, x of n plus 1 is of the advanced in nature, nothing but shifting the sample value from left hand to right side by 1 unit, that is nothing but in the anti-clockwise direction by 1 unit. So you have to start from, for this n plus 1, we have to start from here and in anti-clockwise direction 1 unit, in anti-clockwise direction 1 unit, 1, 2, 3, so corresponding is equal to 231, 231, 231, 231, 231, 1, 3, 1, 2, and like this. This is the way of representing, a way of shifting the periodic sequences. Shifting this periodic sequences. Now, next one. If you represent this, consider a signal of periodic in nature with period is equal to n is equal to 4, the corresponding signal I'm taking as 1, 2, 3, 4. Corresponding signal I'm taking as 1, 2, 3, 4. No need to represent this as the dots. With this dot, signal x of n with period is equal to 4 dimension, then definitely this is a periodic signal and the samples are repeated after every 4 samples. And how can you represent the x of minus n? Now, reversal of this discrete signal. Now, as like this, in n equal to 0, you fix n equal to 1, n equal to 2, and n equal to 3, this is fixed. This is 1, 2, 3 and 4. X of minus 1 is nothing but simply mirror image of this one. How can you get this x of minus 1? Already one more thing is appear here. It exists here. So corresponding x of minus n is nothing but 1, 4, 3, 2. 1, 4, 3, 2 is the corresponding x of minus n. So corresponding can be represented as simply this mirror image of this one only. This is 1. This is 3 is constant, the 4 will become 2, 2 will become this one. So this is equal to n equal to 0, n equal to 1, n equal to 2 and n equal to 3. The corresponding signal can be represented as 1, 4, 3, 2. This is only your x of minus n. This is only your x of minus n. How I have written this x of minus n? Simply, there is a simply I have taken one more periodic information before this one. Just interchange these two and add about this one 2, 3, 4. This is the signal x of minus n. This is the signal x of minus n, that is 1, 4, 3, 2. Again, we have here this periodic in nature and this 1, 4, 3, 2 repeated after every 4 samples. This 4 repeated after every 4 samples. The next one, this is your x of n, this is your x of n, and this is your x of minus n. Now, this is your x of minus n. Now, I am going to write x of minus n plus 1, that is what x of 1 minus n. x of minus n plus 1 is nothing but this is simply minus n plus 1, right? This equate this minus n plus 1 is equal to 0. Simply minus n plus 1 is equal to 0 and minus n equal to minus 1, n is equal to 1, n is equal to 1. Add all these n equal to 1 to all these intervals, so 0 will become 1. So actually this is same 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0 will become 1. So this is equal to 1, 4, 3, 2. This is your x of minus n plus 1. This is your x of minus n plus 1. After this x of minus n plus 1, okay, we will verify whether it is correct or not by using this method. Now I am going to write this x of minus n plus 1. Before we have to write x of n plus 1, right? X of n plus 1, first the position is the order is the shifting followed by the scaling only in the discrete time signal, or in all continuous or discontinuous, wherever we have considered only these two, the procedure only we have considered, which is the shifting followed by reversal. Right. This x of n plus 1 is equal to simply I am representing that this is your x of n, this is your x of n. X of n plus 1 means x of n plus 1 nothing but two samples I am considering, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is your x of n plus 1. This is your x of n plus 1. Now, what we ask? What we want? X of minus n plus 1, right? Simply, x of minus n plus 1 is nothing but simply reverse of this one. This is equal to simply reverse of this 1, 4, 3, 2. 1, 4, 3, 2, you will get. So, the corresponding one-way deformation is equal to 2, 1, 4, 3. Corresponding one-way deformation is equal to 2, 1, 4, 3. This is your x of minus n plus 1. We will verify with the normal method. Here, x of minus n, here, this is the signal x of n. This is the signal x of n. From this, you have to write x of minus n plus 1. But further, the order is the shifting followed by the scaling. So, x of n plus 1 I am considering x of n plus 1 is nothing but simply one unit shifting into left to right side direction. This is the x of n plus 1, but we want is the x of minus n plus 1. We require is the x of minus n plus 1. Corresponding x of minus n plus 1 is equal to 2 here only, the reversal of this one, reversal of this signal. So 1432. So 143, this is the one period information. The corresponding one period information are satisfied with the our information from the circular point of view. Our information is the circular point of view. So if you write x of minus n plus 2, if they ask you to write the x of minus n plus 2, simply first write the x of minus n and shift to all these. Actually, this is looking like an advance. Okay, this is looking like an advance. If you take minus at the common, it will become delayed only. So we have to consider in the delay only. Don't confuse about the advance or shifting or anything. Just equal, write down x of minus n, and equal is minus n plus 1 is equal to 0. Minus n plus 1 is equal to 0 and minus n equal to minus 1 and n is equal to 1. Add this 1 to each and every sample values of the n, like your regular procedure, whatever you have done in the discontinuous shifting operations in the discontinuous signal. Now coming to this x of minus n plus 2, x of minus n plus 2 is nothing but simply add minus 1 plus 2 is equal to 0, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 2. So we have to shift 2 samples in this clockwise direction. This is 1 and this is 2. So we start from here 1, 4, 3. 2, n 4, 3, n equal to 0, n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3. Listen carefully, this is somewhat important for our persons. So the corresponding x of minus n plus 2 will become 3, 2, minus n plus 2 will become 3, 2, 1, 4. If you represent this way, if you represent like this, the x of n plus 2 will become, from the linear shifting point of view, this x of n plus 2 is equal to simply your 1, 2, 3, 4. This is your x of n plus 2. Now x of minus n plus 2 will become 2, 1, 4, 3. This is your one period information. The corresponding value, the corresponding representation is, sorry, this is your x of n plus 2. X of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. X of n plus 2. Where we have to consider? At 3 we have to consider x of n plus 2. This after x of minus n plus 2 is equal to simply 3, 2, 1, 4. This is the signal 3, 2, 1, 4. Okay, this is, I am satisfied with this one. Now, simple conclusion. X of n with this one, you ask to calculate x of minus n plus 2. Simply write down this x of minus n. And after that, simply equate this minus n plus 1 is equal to 0 or whatever. Or depending on this one, shift by 1 unit and shift by 2 units are like that. So this periodic signal, no need to consider the total signal. Even if you are having any confusion, just consider two period information of the given signal x of n. And do by using our conventional method, whatever you have used in the discontinuous signal. Okay, don't go to do this type of calculation only by considering the one period information. We may not write. If you write, if x of n is given as 1, 2, 3, 4, and they ask you to write down x of minus n, this x of minus n will become simply how can you write 2, 3, 4, 1. This is your x of minus n. 0 will become at 1, 0 will become 0, 0 position is always 1 only. This is the value you will get. Okay, these values, sample values are n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. Again, you have to repeat this to 4, 3, 2, 1. This is your required one period information in the x of minus n. Like that, you have to calculate. Okay, at least 2 period information consider and do the conventional procedures, whatever you have done in the normal discontinuous signals, or otherwise use this approach for the periodic signal, periodic discrete signals. Always go through this circular approach only. This is the better approach. Now we will do the convolution of the periodic signal x of n whose period is equal to n equal to 3. Convolution of the signal x of n whose period n equal to 3 is given by 1, 2, 3. Again, 1, 2, 3 I am considering. They ask you to calculate the convolution of this signal itself. Convolution of this signal itself, according to the formula sigma n is equal to minus infinity to infinity. Sigma n is equal to minus infinity to infinity. Infinity x of r into x of n minus r. x of r into x of n minus r. This is your convolution. Limits are from r is equal to minus infinity to infinity. Here the period. Here the signal is the periodic in nature. Whatever the information exists for one period, that period only repeat till up to infinity. So if no need to consider the limits are up to infinity. If we take the limits of one period, that is enough. Consider a discrete time signal 1, 2, 3, 4 whose period n is equal to 4, and you are supposed to calculate the convolution of this signal with itself, x of n, convolution of x of n, the corresponding signal is the y of n, okay, a signal is a periodic signal, the corresponding convolution is called the periodic convolution or the cycle convolution, that you will see how to calculate. Now this y of the convolution can be represented as the sigma x of r into x of n minus r into x of n minus r, and r is equal to from minus infinity to infinity. But here, if you call it easier, the one period information only repeated till minus infinity to infinity. So I am considering the one period information only, one period levels only. So that is from 0 to 3. The corresponding y of 0 is equal to summation r equal to 0 to 3. X of r into x of minus r. The corresponding y of 1 equal to simply substitute n is equal to 1. Simply substitute 1 in place of n. Since this is simply x of 1 minus r. And correspondingly y of 2 is equal to sigma r equal to 0 to 3. X of r into x of 2 minus r. And y of 3 equal to sigma r equal to 0 to 3. X of r. And x of 3 minus r. Because by expanding the summation, we will get the required values y of 0, y of 1, y of 2, and y of 3. In this, if you substitute r is equal to 0, we have x of minus 0. If you substitute r equal to 0 here, we have x of 1. R equal to 2 here, we have x of 1 minus 2, x of minus 1. How can you get x of minus 1? Here, these are the sample values x equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 only. How can you get x equal to minus 1? As it is a periodic thing that is repeated after 4 samples, repeated after 4 samples from minus infinity to infinity. So this x of minus 1 can be treated as a x of minus, x of n can be treated as a periodic signal. X of n is equal to x of n plus or minus m into n, where m is the integer, 1, 2, 3, 4, m is the integer and n is capital N is the period. This m is equal to integer, that is 0, 1, 2, up to so on. This condition to be satisfied, the signal to be periodic. Suppose if you want x of minus 1, this x of minus 1 is equal to simply x of n minus 1. So this is equal to x of 3 minus 1, x of 4 minus 1 here. This is equal to your x of 3. The x of 3 value itself is the x of minus 1, x of minus 3. If you write 1, 2, 3, 4 here also, 1, 2, 3, 4, the corresponding sample value at minus 1 is the x of the corresponding sample value at n is equal to 3. Okay, like this also you can calculate. We will do this analysis by using the circular method. Already we have seen yesterday the representation of x of r in the circular is equal to the representation of x of r in the circular is. This is your n equal to 0, n equal to 2, n equal to 1, n equal to 0, 1, 2, and 3. Corresponding values are represented as 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the sample values I have written on the outside and inside. Those are the sample intervals instances in n equal to 0, n equal to 1, n equal to 2, and n equal to 3. Now, what you want? This x of r to be multiplied with the x of minus r. The x of r to be multiplied with the x of minus r. The corresponding x of minus r is equal to simply the mirror image of this one. Simply n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, mirror image of this one, 1 and 3 are common, this 4 and 2 you will get, this is the corresponding for x of minus r. After that, for y of 1, you want to multiply this x of r with the x of minus r plus 1. Already we have seen yesterday how to write the x of minus r plus 1, right? After writing this x of minus r plus 1 is equal to 0 and r is equal to 1, r is equal to 1. So this will become here 0, 1, 2, 3 are the sample values, and this one sample value at n equal to 0, 1, n equal to 0 will become the sample value at n is equal to 1. So this will become 1, 4, 3, and 2. This is your x of minus r plus 1. X of minus r plus 1. For y of 2, you required x of minus r plus 2. X of minus r plus 2 means again shift this into the 2 units. This corresponding x of minus r plus 2. I am writing here 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 is starts from here. 1, 4, 3, 2. This is your x of minus r plus 2. X of minus r plus 2 for y of 3. We required x of minus r plus 3. For that one, simple. Instead of 2 units, here we have to consider 3 units. So 1, 2, 3. So we start from 1, 4, 3, and 2. These are the corresponding values. These are the corresponding representations of x of minus r, x of minus r plus 1, x of minus r plus 2, and x of minus r plus 3. Now, what you need to do? For y of 0 equal to simply multiplication of this x of r with x of minus r. X of r with x of minus r, by multiplying these two corresponding y of 0 equal to 1 into 1 plus 2 into 4 plus 3 into 3 plus 4 into 2 plus 4 into 2. The value corresponding whatever will appear, that is the final value, this is equal to 1 plus 8 plus 9 plus 8. This is equal to how much? 8 plus 8, 16. 25, 26, this is the value of y of 0. And what about this y of 1? Y of 1 is equal to simply multiplication of x of r with x of 1 minus r, x of r with x of 1 minus r, this multiplication. Now, during these two multiplication, we will get the corresponding value. Y of 1, this value is equal to 1 into 2 plus 2 into 1 plus 4 into 3 plus 3 into 4, whatever the value you will get here, that is the final value. And what about this y of 2? Y of 2 is equal to simply x of r multiplication with x of minus r plus 2. So this is equal to these two multiplication is your y of 2. This is your y of 2. The corresponding y of 2 is equal to, I am writing here, corresponding y of 2 is equal to 3 into 1 plus 3 into 1 plus 2 into 2 plus 1 into 3 plus 4 into 4. 1 into 3 plus 4 into 4. And for y of 3, this is the x of r multiplication with x of minus r plus 3. X of r multiplication with x of minus r plus 3. This value is your y of 3. This y of 3 is equal to simply 4 into 1 plus 3 into 2 plus 2 into 2 plus 3 into 1 plus 3 into 1. These are the corresponding values for the y of 0, y of 1, y of 2, y of 0, y of 1, y of 2 and y of 3. Okay, like this we have to calculate the convolution of this signal. This representation we have to know, but this representation no need to remember, you have to know actually. For this calculation, the same method we will do can be using the matrix. By using the matrix representations, simply represent this one, x of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Here x of 1 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. And again 1, 2, 3, 4 here also. Again 1, 2, 3, 4 here also. Now you need to shift one unit into left side. You need to shift one unit to left side. So this will be shift one unit into right side. That is 1, 2, 3. And this is 4. Again 4, 1, 2, 1. This is 3. Rotation, not shifting, rotation. Rotation from right to left by one unit. Okay, now here it is equal to 3, 4, 1 and this value is equal to 2. This is the matrix formation. Like this you have to format, and after that simply you need to calculate the multiplication. Matrix multiplication, this is 1 into 1 plus 2 into 4 plus 3 into 3 plus 4 into 2 plus 4 into 2. This is only we have 1 into 1, 2 into 4, 3 into 3, 4 into 2. Then after that 1 into 2 plus 2 into 1 plus 3 into 4 plus 4 into 3, 3 into 4 plus 4 into 3. That is the corresponding value for y of 1. 1 into 2, 2 into 1, 4 into 3 and 3 into 4. Then coming to y of 2, this is equal to 1 into 3. 1 into 3 plus 2 into 2 plus 2 into 2 plus 3 into 1 plus 4 into 4 plus 4 into 4. This is the corresponding value for y of 2. This is equal to 1 into 3, 2 into 2, 3 into 1 and 4 into 4. This value, whatever you get. Now, final value y of 3 equal to simply your 1 into 4 plus 2 into 3 plus 3 into 2 plus 4 into 1 plus 3 into 2 plus 4 into 1. This is the corresponding value for the y of 3. 1 into 4, 2 into 3, 3 into 2 and 4 into 1. This is the corresponding value for the and 4 into 1 it is. Here it is 4, here it is 1, this one. sample value 4 into 1, this is the corresponding convolution. This value is equal to simply 1 plus 8 9 plus 9 18 plus plus 8 26 2 plus 2 4 4 plus 12 16 16 plus 12 28 3 plus 4 7 plus 3 10 plus 16 23 plus 16 23 and 4 plus 6 10 plus 6 16 plus 4 20 16 plus 4 20. This is the value you have value you are obtained 26 28 23 and 20. We have to write 4 by 4 in this method. The single row you need to represent is equal to 26 8, 9, 17, 25, 26, 2, 4, 12, 16, 28, 3, plus 4, 7, plus 3, 10, plus 16, 26, 4, 6, 10, plus 6, 16, plus 4, 20. Now we will do this same method using the linear convolution. What is the linear convolution of this x of n with itself? By using the Cantor method. Linear convolution means the conventional convolution only. We will do using the Cantor method 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. The corresponding is multiplication 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 4, 6, 8. 3, 6, 9, 12. 4, 8, 12, 16, 4, 8, 12, 16, after that you have 1, 4, 10, 6, 6, 12, 12 plus 8, 20, 20, 17 plus 8, 25, then 24, then 16, then 16, you have this 1, 4, 10, 20, 25, 24 and 16. Now by seeing this, 25 plus 1, 24 plus 1, 16. This is your 20, this 20. What is the circular convolution? What you got? Circular convolution, what you got is equal to represent here is equal to 20, 20, and move from like this, move from 20 to like this, 20 to like this, 25 plus 1 is 26, 24 plus 4 is 28, 10 plus 16 is 26. Like this also you can calculate the circular convolution from the linear convolution. 26, 28, 26, 28, 26, 10. Any method you can do by going through the normal. Normal method, normal formal method, or you can use the circular convolution circular method, or you can use the matrix method, or you can use the linear convolution and linear convolution method. Of linear convolution, the middle value to be taken as the last, middle value to be taken as the last, and you have to move like this. You have to move from 20 in this way, and you have to starting in this way. These two you have to have 25 plus 4 26, 24 plus 4 28, 16 plus 10 26. Out of this matrix method is you have to remember. This matrix method you have to remember. Now, the given signal is a 4-point signal, x of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and if they ask you to calculate the 5-point circular convolution, then simply add 1, 0 and repeat the procedure whatever you have done till now. For the 4-point circular convolution is this one. If they ask you to calculate the 5-point circular convolution, simply add 1 more 0, 6-point, 1 more 0, you need to add, and then proceed to calculate using the matrix method. But the circular representation we have to know. How can you use the circular representation? It may not useful in the problem's point of view, but you have to remember. In some cases, it will be useful. Okay, those cases we will see in the problems. No problems. Now, the representation, the calculation of the circular convolution. So here the convolution DDFS and DFT. If anyway you listen the word convolution, the corresponding convolution, the periodic convolution, not circular convolution only. Since the signal in the time domain is a periodic signal, in the frequency domain also it is a periodic signal only. The frequency domain convolution or time domain convolution, whatever, that is the circular convolution only because of this periodic nature in the time domain and the frequency domain. Okay, alright, now consider in the continuous in the CDFS, because it is not a new topic or new formula or anything, just extension to the CDFS only. Continuous time Fourier series only. In continuous time Fourier series, how we have represented this x of p is equal to summation n is equal to from minus infinity to infinity. Cn into e to the power j omega naught, that is equal to 2 pi by t naught. I am writing j omega naught into n into t, j n omega naught actually, okay, omega naught 2 pi by t, n and then t, n, there is e power j n omega naught t, this is only the representation for the x of t. Now, the corresponding cn is equal to simply your 1 by t, integration over 0 to t, or 0 to t, or minus t by 2 to t over 1 over 1 period integration, into x of t into e to the power minus j 2 pi by t n into t minus j 2 pi by t n into t. This is the corresponding representation of the exponential Fourier series representation of the x of t. This is only the formula throughout the sequence of gestation you have to remember. Nothing. This is also having some derivation. No need to remember the derivation. This is only the formula you have to remember. Throughout the sequence of gestation, after that, it depends on this formula only. Fourier transform was developed, DTFT was developed, Laplace was developed, Jet transform was developed. Everything was developed. Everything was like a water flow only. This is the source. This is the source actually, you have to remember this one. From that formula only everything was obtained. Already we have seen the total topics, all the topics. Okay, how the formation, how the formation was there. No need to remember any formula. Okay, remember any formula. Just simply like a water flow only. Flow after this subject, after this topic, that topic, like that only. But everything are based on this formula, x of t and x of n. So you have to remember these two formulas, that's it. These two formulas are this is also not a new formula. No need to remember also. How can I generate this formula? Yes, e power j over j n omega naught form say one orthogonal pair over one period. So we can represent any single as algebraic sum of the orthogonal components in the one period 0 to 2 pi omega naught. Thus one period information can extend to the minus infinity like that only you have generated right. X of t equal to n into this one, and this cn is equal to like this 1 by t. Over substituting this x of t equal to here, you will get f cn equal to right hand side, that we have seen already. Actually, even though you have to remember this one, x cn is equal to. Now, coming to this, this is the continuous time signals. Coming to your discontinuous time, this t will become what? T will become nds, and considering this ds is equal to 1, t will become n and that term n will become here k, this t will become n and the corresponding frequency representation cn will become ck, that n will become ck, n will become ck, and because of the discrete in nature the integration will become summation and the corresponding omega naught here is equal to 2 pi by t. Omega naught here is equal to 2 pi by t. The corresponding omega naught here will become is equal to 2 pi divided by n. That is, capital T will become n only. Simple. Nothing. T in continuous time, the period is represented as T. In discontinuation, the corresponding period is represented as the n only. Not anything. Represented as n only. Now I am going to write in the formula. So the corresponding x of n is equal to simply n is equal to from minus infinity to infinity. You have to consider. Here, in the discrete time signal also it is a periodic in nature only. So, one period information is enough to consider. What the period information was repeated up to minus infinity infinity. Up to minus infinity. If you want to prove, we can prove. So, the corresponding value, the corresponding cn will become ck. So, k is equal to from 0 to n minus 1 for one period information. 0 to n minus 1, the corresponding ck value into e to the power j 2 pi by n. T will become n and n will become. What k here? K into m. This n is the corresponding time domain signal n. This k is the corresponding ck. Could equal to 2 pi by n into kn. 2 pi by n into kn. The corresponding ck is equal to simply in place of 1 by 2, you have 1 by n. And integration will become summation because of the discrete in nature. So this is equal to 0 to n minus 1. N is equal to 0 to n minus 1. This x of n into e to the power minus j 2 pi by n. Nk, 2 pi by n, nk, this is only the corresponding representation for the calculation of x of n and ck. Not a new thing, everything was appeared from here only. The calculations, the problems, everything we have to correlate with the continuation of Fourier series questions only. Whatever the calculation of the ck they will give you, whatever the properties for the cn are satisfied here also. If you consider the c minus k is equal to what? Simply in place of k, you have to substitute in place of k. C minus k I am writing. In place of k, you need to substitute minus k. This minus minus will get cancelled. So this can be represented, this can be called as the ck star. The conjugate of the ck is equal to e to the power j 2 pi by n nk. Okay, if you substitute c minus k, you will get the conjugate of this one. So you can call this equal to ck star. We have ck star. So you can represent ck is equal to c minus k star that already we have seen in the cn also. C minus K star. What is the magnitude of this one? CK is equal to C minus K only. The conjugate X plus IY having the same magnitude as the X minus JY. X minus JY, so the corresponding C minus K, magnitude of C minus K is equal to CK only. Magnitude of C minus K is CK only. Now coming to the angle point of view, CK having the angle is equal to angle 2 pi by n into NK. 2 pi by n into NK. Coming to the C minus K angle will become CK angle is equal to magnitude is equal to so total throw this one. So angle of CFK is equal to simply we can write to minus 2 pi by n NK, minus 2 pi by n NK. The corresponding angle C minus K is equal to simply 2 pi by n NK, because K is equal to minus 1, this minus into minus will become plus 2 pi by n into NK. From this we can represent the angle of CK is equal to angle of C minus K. Angle of CK is equal to angle of C minus K, as we have seen in the continuous time Fourier series only. And one more, for the periodic signal we have x of n is equal to, just now we have seen x of n is equal to x of n plus or minus m n, right? Plus or minus m n, m is integer and n is the period. So here x of ck can be represented as ck is equal to simply ck plus or minus m n, ck plus or minus m n, because ck is also periodic in nature. Because here ck is also periodic in nature, whereas in continuous time Fourier series we cannot write the cn is equal to like this. Because the Cn is in the frequency domain, the Cn is not in periodic in nature. So here, because of this periodic property in the frequency domain, we can represent the Ck equal to Ck plus or minus Mn. Now, listen, by drawing the spectrum, we have two times equal to K value, corresponding value equal to Ck, magnitude they will give you and angle they will give you. We can generate the value of X of N as like in the CTFS only. Now listen, the corresponding values of C values are 1, 2, 3, 4 like that, 1, 2, 3, 4 like that, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 like that. The corresponding, suppose this CK exists to, CK exists yet to, the corresponding frequency of this one is equal to simply 2 into omega naught by 2 pi, as like in CTFS. CN is existed to, the corresponding frequency value is equal to 2 omega naught, that is n omega naught, 2 omega naught, 3 omega naught, like that. Here also, if the CK is existed, K is equal to 2, the corresponding frequency component is equal to 2 into 2 pi divided by n. This is the corresponding frequency component. Depending on this frequency component, we'll send it to the some low pass filter or high pass filter or band pass filter, and after that, if the signal is passing through this filter, we'll get the output, the corresponding output with the corresponding output frequency components. These type of problems will be throughout the signals and disturbs. They will give you the time domain signal. After that, the time domain signal is passed through the low pass filter having this much of frequency. What are the output frequency components, or what are the power of the output signal, or what are the energy of the output signal, or whatever. Throughout the signal is this one only. Throughout the signals and disturbs, these type of problems only they are asking also. Okay, even after the If f of t is sampled, the sample spectrum is passed through the low pass filter, what are the frequency components present? Like this also, total are the frequency, based on the frequency components only. Here also, if it is the CTFS Fourier series point of view, the corresponding frequency components are omega naught, n omega naught, wherever the n is there, wherever cn is there, the corresponding frequency component is present. The corresponding component, signal frequency component will be passed through the filter. If it is in the pass point of the filter, so this is directly transferred to the output. Here also, in Fourier transform also, Laplace transform also, Z transform also, wherever. Okay, the main process. Here also the corresponding is the CK. K is equal to, this value K equal to 3 is present. The corresponding frequency is equal to 3 into 2 pi by n. That is the third harmonic we can say fundamental harmonic only present, if after passing through the low pass filter, you will get the output. You have to remember this procedure and this point, and every year of the gate examination, you are basing one question of the based on this frequency components, calculation of this frequency components throughout the signals and disturbs. Okay, right. Don't be confused. Just identify what are the frequency components present in the frequency domain, whether the frequency components are in the range of the pass point of the filter or not. If not, simply output is equal to 0. If available, simply those filter pass to the output of the signal, and then you can calculate the what? Power or energy, whatever they asked you. Now, for f of n, the corresponding is equal to ck, corresponding is equal to ck, then f of n minus n naught, f of n minus n naught is the ck into cn, f of t equal to cn, for f of t minus c naught, corresponding is equal to cn into e to the power minus jn, what is that in the ct of s, f of t minus t naught is equal to corresponding cn into e to the power minus jn omega naught t naught, minus jn omega naught t naught, that's what this one only, here also the ck into e to the power minus j, 2 pi by n into k into n naught, 2 pi by n into k into n naught, simply not a new formulas or anything. Okay, now f of n minus n by 2, what will happen? F of n minus n by 2, this will become ck into e to the power minus j, 2 pi by n into n by 2 into n naught, n by 2 into k, n will get cancelled, 2 will get cancelled. So this is equal to simply ck into minus 1 whole to the power k, since c power minus j pi is equal to minus 1, minus 1 whole to the power k, since this is equal to 1 of the e power j pi is equal to minus 1, e power j pi equal to minus 1. Suppose if ck is equal to like this 1, 2, 3, the corresponding minus 1 whole to the power k is nothing but this ck is equal to 1 minus 2 alternate plus and minuses we have to consider. Now, the frequency shifting property. Frequency shifting property. For ck minus k naught, this value is equal to simply f of n into e to the power j 2 pi by n k naught into n, as a property in the CTFC only, not a new property here. Simply some problem we can treat that problems also. This is equal to ck minus n by 2, what will happen? Ck minus n by 2 equal to f of n into e to the power j 2 pi by n into n by 2 into n equal to get cancelled, and then we get cancelled. So this equal to f of n into minus 1 whole to the power n, since e power j pi is minus 1 only, as the e power minus j pi. This is the corresponding signal for the ck minus n by 2. From this we can conclude if the signal is shifted by the half of the period, is either in the time domain or in the frequency domain. From this we can conclude whether the signal is shifted by the half of the period, whether in the time domain period or in the frequency domain period, the corresponding signal is the same signal with the alternate positive and negative. You can take this as a note. With alternate positive and negatives. That is, if f of n is equal to represent, if f of n is equal to, you can take as a question also. If f of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, they have given 1, 2, 3, 4, they have given. Then they ask for what is the DTFS coefficients of f of k minus 2. f of k minus 2 is nothing but f of k minus n by 2 only. Here the period is n is equal to 4. F of k minus n by 2 only. The corresponding f of inverse, corresponding inverse DT, corresponding x of n for the DTFS coefficient f of k minus 2 is the corresponding f of n is equal to simply f dash n writing is equal to simply 1 minus 2 3 minus 4 with same signal with alternate positive and negative. Now for the signal what is the Fourier series coefficient for f of minus 10? What is the Fourier series coefficient for f of minus 10? This is simply f of minus 10, f of n is ck, f of minus n is equal to simply c minus k, which is equal to ck star. As like in the Fourier transform only, f of t equal to cn and f of minus t equal to c minus n, which is equal to cn star, like that also, f of minus n equal to c minus k equal to ck star. How can you represent this f of minus n? F of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. What about this f of minus n? If f of n is given as 1, 2, 3, 4, then what about this f of minus n? F of minus n equal to simply minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Is it correct? No, simply minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 4 is wrong. This f of minus n is equal to simply by using the circle method you can do instead value equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, by mirror image of this one is equal to simply 1, 4, 3, 2. So corresponding f of minus n is equal to 1, 4, 3, 2. Like that you can represent the corresponding f of minus n or whatever, 1, 4, 3, 2. Or if you want to write, you have to consider one more period here also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is your one, this is your corresponding minus one in the thing, but simply we have image of this one, this is equal to 1432. So this is the corresponding signal, and the signal is even, what is the condition is that f of n is equal to f of minus n, this is equal to f of minus n plus n, f of minus n plus n. If the condition is satisfied, the corresponding signal is said to be even signal. If f of n, in f of n they will give you, f of n they will give you this f of n is equal to simply 1, 2, 2, 1, simply 1 to 2 1. If they ask you to calculate whether the given signal is the even signal or not, even signal or not, you need to verify this f of n is equal to f of minus n. This f of n is equal to f of minus n. Simply substitute 1 to 2 1. The mirror image of this one is equal to 1 to 2 1 2. So this is not a even signal. This is not even signal. Or we can verify like this also. So the better is the circular method. So you have to remember how to represent and how to do. Okay, in single step, in single minute, you can conclude the answer. Then conclude the answer. Now next one. F of n shifting property. This one f of n minus 2. And the power of the signal is equal to simply as like that of the continuous time for a sample transformer is equal to simply ck square only. Simply summation ck square where k is equal to from 0 to n minus 1 for the one period information. K equal to 0 to n minus 1. K equal to 0 to n minus 1. Next, write down some formulas. Not a formula, write down some problems. The models you will see is a very, very easiest questions, very, very easiest topic of this DTFS and the DFT. And we will see the DFT also. We have ck is equal to here. Ck is equal to here equal to 1 by n. Sigma k sigma n is equal to 0 to n minus 1. 0 to 1 minus 1 f of n into e to the power minus j 2 pi by n. Nk 2 pi by n nk. This DFT mean this DFT equal to n into ck is equal to simply n into ck is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to n minus 1 f of n into e to the power minus j 2 pi by n. Nk, this is the function of k. The corresponding is called the DFT. The corresponding is called the DFT. The DFT is equal to n into ck, or the DFS coefficient is equal to simply DFT divided by n. DFT divided by n. Now from this the corresponding f of n is equal to sigma k equal to from 0 to n minus 1 ck into e to the power j 2 pi by n nk. 2 pi by n nk, very easy, you can write e power j 2 pi by n nk. The corresponding substitute is ck equal to f of k divided by n. So this is equal to 1 by n sigma k equal to 0 to n minus 1 f of k into e to the power j 2 pi by n nk. 2 pi by n nk, this is your signal f of n. That is called the inverse DFT is called the IDFT. inverse DFT. This is the corresponding DFT f of k. Not a new formulas or not a new thing, everything. This is like your Fourier transform only. Fourier transform equal to integration of f of t into e to the power minus j omega t. Right? Because under the continuous, so you have considered omega t. This is discontinuous, you have to come in place of omega, you have to take the n omega naught only. Because of that omega, you will become n omega naught, n into 2 pi by n into k. N into 2 pi by n into k. That k is nothing but your omega. Right. Okay, 2 pi by n into k, the corresponding is the DFT, corresponding is this IDFT. Now is this DFT also, is of the periodic in nature. So you can call this DFT f of k is equal to f of k plus or minus, no need to write actually, f of k plus or minus mn. Now we will see what is f of n minus k what will happen. f of k equal to this one, you have to substitute in place of k, f of n minus k, what will happen, you will see. This equal to simply sigma n equal to 0 to n minus 1 f of n into e to the power minus j 2 pi by n minus j 2 pi by n into, in place of n you have to substitute n minus k into k, n minus k into k. This is the signal sigma, this is the summation. This is equal to summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1. This f of n into e to the power minus j 2 pi by n. N will get cancelled. We can get e power minus j 2 pi k, into e to the power j 2 pi by n. What happened? In place of k this is n minus k 2 pi by n into n e power j 2 pi by n into n into k, because minus into minus will plus j 2 pi by n into n into k. This value e power minus j 2 pi whole to the power k, when e power minus j 2 pi whole to the power k, that value is equal to 1 only. So this is equal to same n equal to 0 to n minus 1 f of n into e to the power j 2 pi by n nk, j 2 pi by n nk. This can be called as the conjugate of this f of k. This is equal to conjugate of this f of k. So f of n minus k is equal to simply conjugate of this f of k. Here the conjugate of this f of k is equal to minus minus plus, and we have the corresponding value is equal to conjugate of f this f of k, f of n minus k is equal to, that is nothing but if n is equal to period up to 0 of the period is equal to n, that is nothing but 0 to 3, right? The corresponding f of 1 is equal to simply f star of 3 minus 1 is equal to f star of 2. If you know the value of f of n, directly you can conclude about the f of 2 by taking the conjugate of this one. Now, from this formula, so I am going to write in the f of 0 is nothing but simply factor f of 0 is equal to in place of k, substitute in place of k, substitute as 0, that will become summation of f of n only, all the summation of the sample values, directly you can write the f of 0 by adding all the sample values. Similarly, what about this f of n by 2 is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1. If you substitute in place of k n by 2, n will get cancelled, 2 will get cancelled, we have it is equal to minus j pi. E power minus j pi equal to minus 1. So this is equal to f of n into minus 1 whole to the power n, f of n into minus 1 whole to the power n. That is summation of all the samples with alternate positive and negative. And after that, nothing but is equal to f of 2, you can say if n is equal to 2, if n is equal to 4, the corresponding value can be read as f of 2. And if you know the value of f of 1, the corresponding f of 2 equal to simply conjugate of this f of 1. So by calculating the DFT of the signal f of n, period is equal to 4, simply we have to consider on calculation of the value of f of 1. If for position directly by adding we can get the f of s, by adding the alternate positive and negative we will get the value of f of 2. Okay, if we have the f of 1, the corresponding conjugate, if we consider the required value of f of 2, f of 2 will be obtained. Now the next one, like your area properties of the Fourier transform, substitute n is equal to 0 here, simply f of 0 is equal to 1 by n into, summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1, f of k, this equal to n into f of 0, is equal to sigma k equal to 0 to n minus 1, f of k, this is your area property only. T into f of 0 is equal to integration of the f of omega d omega, integration nothing but summation. Here we are concentrating only about one period, so this is equal to simply n into f of 0, at that place that is 2 pi into f of 0, 2 pi is at that place we have 2 pi into f of 0, in place of 2 pi we are having n into f of 0. Then after that, ESG property, the energy of the signal E is equal to simply what was that, 1 by 2 pi into integration minus infinity f of omega whole square d omega, this is the corresponding energy of the signal E in the continuation of Fourier transform. Here this E is equal to simply 1 by n into summation n is k equal to from 0 to n minus 1, magnitude of f of k whole square only, equal to 1 by n 0 to n minus 1 magnitude of f of k whole square. We can consider energy E is the energy of the signal f of n, that is your ESG property, you can call correlation to your area property. Then f of n convolution with some g of n. Here the convolution is called the circular convolution. The representation of the circular convolution is like this. f of n circular convolution is g of n. this is equal to simply f of k into g of k, simply f of k into g of k, simply multiplication in the time domain with respect to DFT point of view. This is the DDFS point of view. If f of n is having the coefficient ck, f of n is having the coefficient ck, and g of n is having the coefficient dk, the corresponding is equal to the corresponding in the frequency domain is simply n into ck dk. Already we have seen in the Fourier transform, and how the derivation also we have seen. The similar way, if you go to the derivation, you will get this value only, n into ck dk, n into ck dk. Now with respect to DFT point of view, in reverse way, this with respect to DDFS point of view only, here f of k circular convolution with g of k is the corresponding value. Here is equal to simply, n into f of n into gn, n into f of n into g of n, n into f of n into g of n. Now if we simply for f of n circular convolution is equal to simply f of k into g of k. Here f of k circular convolution, you have f of n into g of n, corresponding is equal to f of k convolution with g of k, like this one. No need to write this n here. F of n is equal to f of k convolution with g of k. Now in a Fourier transform, you have f of t into g of t is equal to what you have written, 1 by 2 pi into f of omega convolution with g of omega, 1 by 2 pi f of omega convolution with g of omega, right? In Fourier transform, here also f of n into g of n is equal to f of n into g of n is equal to 1 by n into f of k convolution with g of k. Here also f of n into g of n is equal to f of n into g of n is the 1 by n f of k convolution with f of corresponding convolution equal to your circular convolution only, 1 by n f of k circular convolution with g of k. These are the convolution properties of the DDFS and the DFT. Now, some properties and some information we have seen, and how to calculate the f of k, that nothing but DFT coefficient, and how to calculate the Fourier series coefficients we will see. DDFS coefficients we will see here. This f of k is equal to simply sigma n is equal to 0 to n minus 1, f of n into e to the power minus j 2 pi by n into nk, right? Now here, I'm considering the period is equal to 4, that is nothing but n is equal to from 0 to 3 and k is equal to from 0 to 3. It is simply multiplication of this. This value e power minus j 2 pi by nk with the term of f of n only, right? Simply multiplication of this term with the f of n only. So I am considering the matrix point of view. I am considering here the f of n. That is nothing but f of 0, f of 1, f of 2, f of 3, and we have to arrange on this matrix that along the rows point, I am considering the value of n, here equal to value of k. Whatever you are supposed to calculate, that value you have to consider here. Okay, I am going to calculate this f of k. Is carefully, very, very easiest method to calculate the DFT. Okay, listen. Very, very easiest way to calculate the DFT and DDFS. This whatever the value you have to calculate, the term to be considered here. This f of k I am going to calculate. So I am considering here. This is your n. The corresponding term is equal to multiplication term equal to e power minus j 2 pi by n into nk, multiplication of these two, n into k. You can consider. So here up to how much value? 0, 1, 2, 3. N is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 2, 3 is better to consider as a table. Then we may not get any confused. Suppose here this nk value is equal to throughout this one, this nk value is 0, 0 into 0, 0, 0 into 1, 0, 0 into 2, 0, 0 into 3, 0, right? 0 into 3, 0. So e to the power minus j 2 pi n into 0 means e power 0 only. But this entire row, this value, e power 0, which is equal to 1. So blindly you can substitute here equal to 1. And coming to this column also, the 0 into 0 is 0, 0 into 1 is 0, 0 into 2 is 0, 0 into 3 is 0. For this entire column also, this value is equal to 1 only. Just now we have seen for f of 0 equal to summation of the samples only. Upon doing the matrix multiplication, we have 1 into f of 0, 1 into f of 1, 1 into f of 2, 1 into f of 2. This is simply summation of the sample values of the given signal f of n only. And after that, already we have seen that f of 2, if we consider this value is equal to n by 2 term, right? For n by 2 term, which is equal to this is your n by 2 term. This is your n by 2 term. N by 2 term is equal to simply alternate positive and negative. Otherwise, you substitute here equal to 2 into 0 is equal to 2. One circle, one go. It was over. 2 into 1 is equal to 2. You substitute here is equal to 2. We have here is equal to 2. We have n into k. This n into k. 2 into 1 is equal to 2. So e to the power minus j. 2 pi by 4 into 2, 2 2 will get cancelled, we have e power minus j pi, e power minus j pi is equal to simply minus 1, for this one 2 into 2 is equal to 4, 2 into 2 equal to 4, 4 get cancelled and e power j 2 pi is equal to 1, okay got it, e power j 2 pi is equal to 1 and after that 2 into 3, 6, 6 we have to substitute the nothing but e power minus j, 12 pi divided by 4, e to the power minus j, 12 pi by 4 cancel e power minus j 3 pi equal to minus 1, minus 1. So first question I am writing for the Indian next onwards. No need to write. Here all are ones. The term the row corresponding to n by 2 is the alternate ones and minus 1. Alternate positive 1 negative 1s. 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1. In this direction also here equal to minus 1, minus. This was already over. Everything is over. Now coming to this one, this value you have to calculate. This is the term related to n into k is equal to 1. N into k is equal to 1. So corresponding value equal to minus j 2 pi by 4 into 1 is equal to e to the power minus j pi by 2. The corresponding value is equal to minus j. And no need to calculate this one also. This is the simply the conjugate of this one only. This is equal to j directly you can write. And this is simply the conjugate of this one only. J directly you can write. The conjugate of this one equal to minus j you can write directly. If you want, try to calculate. This value is equal to 1 into 3, that is equal to 3. That equal to 3 in place of 1, we will get the 3 value. So the corresponding is equal to e to the power minus j 3 pi by 2. Minus j 3 pi by 2 is equal to minus j. Minus j 3 pi by 2 is nothing but in the 5 plus pi by 2. In the third quadrant sign is negative, already negative is there in the formula, so minus j into minus 1 is equal to j you will get, which is equal to j you will get, directly you can form the table for n is equal to 4, how can you form the table for n is equal to 8 we will see, n equal to 6 we will see first, then we will go for the n equal to 8, no need to calculate all the things, mainly they will concentrate on the 0 term or 2 term or any one term. Further directly you can consider. Because this is the formation for n equal to 8 I am writing here. Then it is equal to simply n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 5, 6, 7. Up to 7 samples you need to consider. Here also 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here is the value n, here is the value k, the corresponding is equal to. For 8 I am considering, for n is equal to 8, it is simply the table should contain the 8 rows and the 8 columns. Simply the table should contain 8 rows and 8 columns. The first row is always all are ones only. Just fill it one. And the row corresponding to n is equal to n by 2, that is equal to n equal to n by 2, that is 4. The corresponding value is simply alternate positive and negative. Here also alternate positive and negative minus 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1. This is the table already we got. Now we have to calculate the values here 1 into 1. Here 1 into 1. If you are in position to fill this table, automatically the conjugate of this is the this table, the conjugate of this is the this table, and the conjugate of this is the this table. Or indirectly you calculate all the cells. Indirectly you calculate all the cells of this one. So you have to concentrate how to calculate these values. This value is very, very simple. 1 into 1 is equal to 1 directly. Here is equal to e to the power minus j. Pi by 4 actually, it is equal to e to the power minus j pi by 4. If you substitute 1 into 1 here, it is simply e to the power minus j pi by 4, minus j pi by 4. If you substitute 1 into 2, it is simply e to the power into 2. This cancel. This is equal to simply minus j. And for this one 1 into 3, then that is equal to simply e to the power minus j 3 pi by 4. E to the power minus j 3 pi by 4. That is equal to pi minus pi by 4, right? Which quadrant? Second quadrant, positive negative, no need to write anything. So simply substitute e to the power minus j 3 pi by 4, minus j 3 pi by 4. And after that, if we go into that side, this f of 1 is equal to conjugate of this one is equal to e to the power j pi by 4, conjugate of this one, here is equal to j, and conjugate of this one is equal to e power j 3 pi by 4, and multiply the corresponding values with the required with the given f of n values, and this conjugate of this one is equal to your f of 7 only. If we have this f of 1, indirectly we are having the f of 7 also. That is simply e to the power j pi by 4 conjugate of this one only, j e to the power j 3 pi by 4, e to the power minus j 3 pi by 4, minus j, and e to the power minus j pi by 4, e to the power minus j pi by 4. This is also over. Next for 2, you simply substitute 2 into 1 is equal to 2, the corresponding value is equal to minus j only, then 2 into 3, 6, the corresponding is 1 into 6 already we have calculated, so the corresponding 2 into 3, 6 value is equal to simply j only, got it, 1 into 6 already we have calculated, 2 into 3 means 6, 6 already we have calculated, that equal to here. 2 into 2 is 4, 1 into 4 already we have, if you consider 2 into 2, 4, we have simply minus 1 only, so you don't need to do anything, simply 4 for cancel e power minus j pi equal to minus 1, already we are having this, the conjugate of this one equal to, this conjugate of this is the corresponding cells here, equal to minus j, let's come into this one, 3 into 1 is 3, already we have 3 into 1, so this is equal to simply e to the power minus j 3 pi by 4, then 3 into 2 is 6, already we are having 2 into 3, so this is equal to simply j, then 3 into 3 is 9, you are not having 3 into 3 9, so you need to calculate this cell, which is equal to simply e to the power j 9 pi by 4, the simplification we will do later, minus j 9 pi by 4, so here equal to e to the power j 9 pi by 4, here the corresponding conjugate of this one is minus j, here equal to e power j 3 pi by 4, already we are having these two, but directly you can substitute here, this much are n equal to 8, this much are big table, they will never ask, they will mainly ask the n equal to 4, up to n is equal to 4, or maximum n is equal to 6 only, if n is equal to 8, they ask along with the, by mixing the some properties of the DFT, they will ask with the period n is equal to 8, and if you want to calculate, simply the risk is you have to concentrate the calculation of these four cells only, not a new cell, these four cells were generated, with this row was generated, and with the sum cells of this row only, these cells were generated, we have not calculated any new thing here. And then simply multiply with the corresponding sample values, you will get the required DFT. If they ask you to calculate the inverse DFT then, that is equal to simply f of n is equal to, 1 by n, sigma k is equal to 0 to n minus 1, f of k into e to the power j 2 pi by n, nk, here the required value is equal to n, so here you need to consider the value of n, and here is the value of k, and the corresponding product term is equal to e to the power j 2 pi by n, nk instead of minus j, it will become plus j, this is only the difference, and finally you have to divide with n, same procedure you can follow, and simply divide it, then you will get the corresponding f of n. If you do 2-3 problems practice, it will be very easiest method to calculate. Otherwise, no, I don't want to use this one, then you simply calculate them. You simply calculate this f of k in terms of n. That is nothing but this f of k is equal to f of 0, n is equal to 0, f of 1 into e to the power minus j 2 pi by n k, plus f of 2 into e to the power minus j 2 pi by n 2 k, plus f of 3 into e to the power minus j 2 pi by n 3 k, and from this you can calculate the f of 0, f of 1, f of 2, f of 3, whatever, f of 2, whatever, if substitute n equal to 0, you have all the summation, if substitute n is equal to k equal to 2, you have already positive and negative, if substitute n equal to 1, n equal to 1, we have the value, the conjugate of this one is equal to, we have f of 3, whichever you feel easy, then you can get, this is, looks direct formulas only, there is no confusion at all, but it is complex, this is seeing some confusion is there, but this method is very easy. Confusion was clear. This method is very easy to calculate the DFT for any type of the questions. Then.